Hello, it's Jang here with a look at LEGO Bionicle's Kopaka Master of Ice, a 97-piece set. There he is, complete. The stature of this figure is impressive. He ties with Tahu for tallest Toa, but Kopaka is arguably more heavily armored, probably second only to Onua in that department. Good use of the large fist pieces, or hand pieces, to cover up the fronts of the shoulders. He has more armor than normal on the legs, including armor on the backs of the lower legs. His frost shield is absolutely huge, almost to the point of being unwieldy. The weapon in his right hand is called an elemental ice spear. The action mechanism on Kopaka is attached only to that right hand, so you can spear from underneath, or you can kind of whip on somebody from up above. There is some interference with the shoulder armor if you have it down in a nice looking place, so you kind of have to move that out of the way. Fortunately, you can to get more range of motion, but just requires a little bit of clearance there. But it all does work out, depends upon what your priority is. You can still get it in a fairly good place there, but there you can see it's actually limiting how far up the arm will go. So maybe you turn it this way, now you can go much farther, but does not look good from the front. So for posing, these work out well in that you can move them all kinds of different ways, but for using the action figure, it does limit you a little bit. There's what they use for gearing on the back, so you can see how that is hooked up. Pretty straightforward and very easy to change this around, adding just a few pieces to make it work against both arms. The shield uses pieces molded in white that were also included in the Tahu set in silver there. And instead of going with fire inserts, this one goes with the frost or icy inserts. It's the exact same piece, just molded in different colors. You can see they've combined together the opaque white with the transparent light blue, and it just kind of fades together. Kopaka also uses the transparent light blue color for the hands and the lower arms, same side to side there, and also for the lower legs, which are of the type that have a little extra length added for two Technic pinholes on opposite sides of the center ball section. This does have two stickers on the entire set, one here and one here. They're the exact same, and he gets a very nice print. Not sure about the use of gold on this character. It's new and it's unusual, but it's not too jarring. I think it worked out okay, and what really helps to tie the whole color scheme together is this printed chest armor piece, the breastplate, if you will, because it has a metallic backing behind it. Silver metallic is actually printed over the gold to give you that extra shine, and then they have the translucent, or actually transparent blue that's printed over that to make it look extra metallic. And I think that just looks very nice. The head, the mask on this one, looks very, very, very authentic and just correct and appropriate, and it's really based on his original mask, his true original very first mask from way back in 2001, and that's really good to see, and it does work well in my opinion with this character and with the new aesthetic of the new system. And the set also does include, of course, the gold version of his mask. Notice he's got the light bluish, our transparent light blue color for the brain stock, if you will, underneath. And the gold, of course, is going to fit in well with the rest of the armor because it is the same color. And this set comes with the silver, kind of dark metallic silver colored skull spider. Do not recommend trying to even attempting to attach this without removing at least the front legs. There's just really not a good amount of space under there to put it all on. But you can keep the hind legs on, which really kind of helps to mix the bulk together. You know, it gives you that little bit of filling in between the head and the shoulders. Now the frost shield can be removed and split into two parts to convert it into a pair of what they call avalanche skis for this set. Those clip directly onto the feet, and I think they look really good. The shape, the proportions, and also just where the blue comes out in the front and how that is shaped, I think really adds a lot of momentum, just makes it look like the figure is moving or is about to move, has the power to move very quickly. So I think that's a good little transformation there. All told, I feel like Kopaka gets one of the more dignified figures. That's to say nothing about the character, but the figure looks very complete, looks very confident. The build looks solid, it feels solid, has little things that you do have to adjust for range of motion. And I feel like the way that the lower leg armor is attached is a little bit on the cheap looking side, just because they do separate them front to back so far. It makes it much easier to assemble that way, but that's just a small little thing subjectively that bugs me a little bit. The shield is great. The weapon is a little bit on the plain side. And the one last thing that's questionable is the choice of gold and bringing gold into his color scheme. I feel like it worked out pretty well. And I do feel that the breastplate on the front really helps to tie that together, because it brings in the white and the blue, and also has that metallic nature to it that really seems to connect well. I personally, if I was designing this set to begin with, I would not have used the gold. Probably would have used gunmetal or silver or more white or a combination of those, just to switch things up a little bit. But they did use gold, and I think it doesn't look bad. Overall, this is easily one of my favorite sets from the first wave of the reboot of Bionicle. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. If you like the set, if you don't like the set, if you have any comments about the gold or any other specific features and attributes of it, please feel free to share your thoughts. Thank you in advance for your feedback. Thank you for your time in watching this video. Hope it was enjoyable and informative for you, and hope that you'll stick around to check out more of my videos, because more are on the way very soon. Bye for now.